about my homemade water purification filter. Water purification is a process of removing impurities and contaminants from water to make it safe for drinking and other uses. To make dirty water clean and drinkable, so I use simple things like a plastic glass, big stones, small stones, sand and cotton. At the first step, pour the dirty water into the glass then fill with big stones like this. Big stones cleans the bigger particles in the dirty water. At the second step, small stones cleans the smallest, tinier particles in the dirty water. At the third step, sand cleans the smallest particle in the dirty water. At the fourth and last step, cotton cleans the smallest particles in the dirty water. And finally, clean water comes out. I turn the dirty water into a clean, safe and drinkable. Thank you for listening to me, Anha Hafiz.
Hello, Assalamu Alaikum. My name is Ashad. I am in class 7. Today I am going to show you a type of energy. As you listened before, air energy, solar energy and thermal energy. But my project is totally about heat energy. As you can see, there was a fan on the base and there are 4 candles under the fan. This is called a carousel. How heat energy works? See, when I lighten the candle, when I lighten the candle, the carousel will move due to the heat molecules rising in the form of smoke. You can see the power of heat energy in my project.
Assalamu alaikum. My name is Alina Fatma from class 5. Today I am here to present my project, which is a water dispenser. A water dispenser is a device that provides a convenient source of drinking water. Some water dispenser provide clean, filtered water. As you can see here, when I open, the water is dripping in the glass. When I close the cap, the water is stopped. Some water dispenser can be useful in home, offices, hospitals, etc. Thank you for listening. Allah Hafiz.
Good morning and assalamu alaikum. My name is Hania Parvez and I am a student of class 5. Today I am here to present you my project, which is respiratory system. The main job of respiratory system is to move fresh air into your body and remove waste gases like carbon dioxide. And now I am going to tell you about how this system works. We bring air in through our nose. That air then passes through the larynx into windpipe, which is called a trachea. Then our trachea spreads into 2 bronchi, which goes into each of our 2 lungs. And then air is also, the air is also exhaled, flowing back through the same pathway. And this process is called the respiratory system. Thank you for listening to me. Allah Hafiz.
My name is Arfa and I am from class 2. Today the topic of my presentation is bubble cavity. There are 4 types of heat in a bubble cavity. Incisors, canine teeth, molars and premolars. Incisors. The teeth in the front of the mouth which are used for cutting and biting food. These 8 teeth which cut food are called incisors. Canine teeth. The pointed teeth beside your incisors are called canine teeth because these teeth are pointed and also sharp. There are 4 canines, 2 in each jaw, molars and premolars. The bigger and flatter teeth at the back of the mouth are called molars and premolars. They help us to chew and grind food. They are the toughest teeth in our bubble cavity. Thank you.
Circulatory system is
transportation system. It controls blood, blood vessels and heart. A heart is a strong muscle that pumps blood. It has four chambers that work together to send blood to the body. Blood vessel artery carry blood away from the heart. Vein bring blood back to the heart. Blood carries nutrition, oxygen and waste material throughout the body. Importance of circulatory system. It ensures all parts of the body to get oxygen properly. I hope that you understand my topic on circulatory system. Thank you.
Assalamu alaikum. My name is Mohammad Zaman and I study in class 6 today. My topic of presentation is human excretory system. The human excretory system removes waste chemicals from the body. The removal of waste chemicals is called excretion. The human excretory system consists of a pair of kidneys which are readily on the shell structure situated towards the back of the abdomen. Each kidney has a narrow tube ureter which passes to the urinary bladder. The urinary bladder is a thin walled muscular bag situated towards the bottom of the abdomen. Leading from the bladder is a tube urethra which runs down and open outside the body. All these parts work together to keep the right amount of water and get rid of waste chemicals from the body. I hope that you like my presentation. Thank you.
Assalamu alaikum. My name is Manu Rishta from Class 6. Here I am discussing my project topic, which is solar system. The solar system is made up of the sun and the eight planets and their moons also, and many thousands of smaller objects called comets and asteroids. All of these objects are kept in their orbits around the sun by the sun's powerful gravity. Number two, the sun is the center of our solar system and the planets revolve around it. This is called revolution. Number three, Mercury is the closest planet from the sun. Similarly, Neptune is farthest planet from the sun. Number four, the moon is natural satellite. Thank you for everyone. Hope you all like my presentation.
Assalamu alaikum. I am Hira from class 7. Today the topic of my presentation is about the human heart. The human heart is divided into four chambers. The upper two chambers are called right atrium and left atrium. The lower two chambers are called right ventricle and left ventricle. The three of the generated blood from superior vena cava and inferior vena cava is collected in right atrium and then enter in right ventricle. Correcting of ventricle, this deoxygenated blood now enter in pulmonary artery to the lungs for oxygenation. Now,
sir, I'm with you. My name is Rahul and I'm from class 6. I'm here to share you some information about the respiratory system. The respiratory system is responsible for exchange of gases such as bringing in oxygen and removing carbon dioxide from the body. It consists of several organs including the nose, trachea, lungs and diaphragm. The trachea, commonly known as the windpipe, carrier from the nose to the lungs. When it enters to the lungs, where alveoli are present in which exchange of gases take place. It is important to maintain lung healthy by avoiding smoking and exercise regularly to maintain a healthy environment. When we inhale, the diaphragm moves upwards and lungs become expanded. And when we exhale out, the diaphragm moves downwards and lungs become contracted. For example,
from class 7. Today I am here to present my project, which is on sea animals. Like humans, animals and other living things live on surface. Many living things also live under the water. Our earth is covered with 71% of water. There is whole world lies under the sea and many living things live there which are known as sea animals. The most sea animals which I am showing here are seal, octopus and flying fish. Most of them are vertebrates and belong to different classes of vertebrates. Like dolphin, whale and seal belongs to vertebrates. And I also shown some invertebrates animals like dolphins, seal and etc. Most of them are also mammals like whale and dolphins. Thank you.
Good morning and Assalamu alaikum. I am Hassan Abbas from class 5. As you can see in my project, there is a clear supply system of electricity all over the imagination. There are electric poles and towers all over there. But see, inside the window, there is no electricity at all. But through solar energy, we can solve this problem. First of all, we install the solar panels on our roofs. When sun rises, the energy reacts with solar panels and produce direct current DC. It's called electricity. My project defines that through solar energy we can produce electricity. Thank you for listening. Allah Hafiz.
Assalamu alaikum. My name is Sayyida Mahir and I am from class 5.
becomes soft. Step number 2. The seed leaves become soft and open. Step number 3. The root begins to grow downward, spreading to find water. Step number 4. Leaves appears on the shoot. Last step 5. Eventually the buds appear and these blossoms into flowers which produce seed. Thank you.
Long.
The quadrant log is a log which controls the high-level cognitive skills and primary motor functions. Number 2. Parietal lobe. The parietal lobe is vital for sensory integration, such as including the management of hearing, looking, smelling, tasting, etc. Number 3. The occipital lobe. The occipital lobe helps us to recognize faces, depth and distance of the area, and colors, objects, subjects, and etc. other things. Number 5 is temporal lobe. The temporal lobe is helps our brain to give answer or to respond to the world around us. Number 5 is cerebrum. The cerebrum makes us responsible to move our muscles during the cycling, walking, running, swimming, driving, and other activities. Number 6, final, is medulla oblongata. The medulla oblongata, its second name is brain stem. It is joined our brain from our spinal cord. I hope you gain some of the knowledge from my project. Thank you for your precious time and listening. Allah Hafiz.
Earth takes 24 hours to complete one rotation. It is a sphere. It is divided into two equal parts. At any point in the time, half of the Earth sphere is in the day and night. During the night time, it will be dark, but some amount of sunlight will be received due to the reflect by the moon. Thank you.
Assalamu alaikum. My name is Tayyaba Batul and I am from class 8. So today, I am here to teach you my project, the Human Excretory System.
It consists of a pair of kidneys, a pair of ureter, a urinary bladder, and a urethra. When the blood comes from heart to kidneys, it will filter by glomerulus, and then the left out material like urea will transport it to urinary bladder by ureters. Ureters are narrow tubes which collect urine from kidney to bladder. Bladder is a stretchable bag which collects urine in it. Then the last part is urethra. When the urinary bladder has to be empty, the urethra helps the urinary bladder to excrete urine out of the body.
Now, here I am going to show you how the excretory system works by doing the project. Now, here you see I am going to add the liquid which is yellowish in color. I am going to add it like this. And you will see that the urine goes to the from the kidneys to the ureter, which is 3 to 4 mm tube, and then the urinary bladder, which stores the urine, and the last one is the urethra, which opens outside and excretes the urine. So thank you so much for listening our speech. Allah Hafiz.